Hello, my name is Chris Norbury. I'm one of the tutors at Queen's, and I teach students who are studying medicine or biomedical sciences. Medicine at Oxford is a six-year course, and that divides neatly into 3 years of preclinical study and 3 years of clinical training. Whereas biomedical sciences is becoming a four-year integrated master's course. It was previously a three-year course, and that will give you an opportunity in the fourth year to really get stuck into some serious laboratory research. So my contribution to the college side of the teaching on those courses is to teach all the students in their first 3 years, and I teach biochemistry and medical genetics to the first year medical students, and then a course called Principles of Pathology to the second year students, whereas other tutors in the college will take care of other courses like physiology and pharmacology and organization of the body. So we have some tutors attached to the college who are also consultants up at the John Radcliffe who will take care of your anatomy teaching, for example, and still further tutors who will take care of the neuroscience teaching. And then in the third year of the course, I run one of the options in the what we call the final honors school, an option in molecular pathology, where we mostly focus on cancer cell biology. For the biomedical scientists, I teach them throughout their first year for tutorials in cells, molecules, and genes. And similarly, then whether or not I teach them later in their course will depend very much on which options they choose from a menu of options in their second year and third year. So for both of these courses, about half of the teaching is conducted through college tutorials, with the other half being taken care of on the South Parks Road site for the first 3 years of medicine and for the equivalent part of the biomedical sciences course. So lectures and practicals will happen there, but the tutorials will happen in the college. And without a shadow of a doubt, the thing that I enjoy most about my engagement with the teaching in the college is the conversations with the students. And it's really astonishing that from time to time, I'll have a tutorial with a student, maybe a tutorial I've given 10 times before to different students, but in this one conversation, we'll come up with an idea that I've never really thought about before. And it's a great way for me to learn, as well as for, I hope, the students to learn about the science that makes medicine work. So I've been asked to tell you a bit about things that I like to do personally outside of academia. So a couple of things I do are cycling. So I'm one of those irritating cyclists that you see out on the country roads. And the other thing that I do when I have spare time is to meet with other scientists and medics. We have a band that meets together at the Institute of Molecular Medicine at the John Radcliffe Hospital, and we play loud guitar-based music, and sometimes we're allowed to do that in front of live audiences at conferences and institute parties and things like that, which is great fun. To return to the question of how we select students, now both of these courses on which I teach are quite heavily oversubscribed, but I wouldn't let that put you off. If you're interested in the structure of the course, then please do put in an application. So what we're looking for is students who are really, really into their science. It's as simple as that. And people who are excited by the idea that it's possible to understand something about how human cells work, for example, something about how viruses work. So if you have interests in those areas, and if you can explain to us during the course of the application process why you find those aspects that you find interesting, fascinating, then you're likely to do very well. It's as simple as that. There are additional qualities that we're looking for in students for the medicine course. So those relate to suitability for a career in medicine. And so we're looking for candidates who can demonstrate their ability to imagine what it might be like to be someone else, like a patient, for example. And for candidates who have an understanding of the ethical considerations that operate around medicine and so on. My top tip for interviews, preparing for interviews, is to encourage you to find whatever opportunity opportunities you can to have conversations about science, and if you're applying for medicine, about medicine too. With almost anybody, actually, could be conversations with a teacher if they have time, but otherwise with a family member or with one of your contemporaries, just to explore within those conversations the basis of your own enthusiasm. And if you can find opportunities to do that, you'll probably learn something about your enthusiasm for science and medicine as well. And the interview will be in the nature of a conversation. And that's in part because we're trying to identify candidates who stand to benefit the most from the style of teaching that we offer here. So our unique selling point is the small group teaching session, the tutorial teaching. So we're trying to find the candidates who would most benefit from that style of teaching, which is conversational. And so the interview will be conversational. So if you're prepared to engage in a conversation, you're likely to do well. That's not to say that you should sit there talking the whole time, but engage in a two-way exchange of ideas that involves listening as well as talking. If you like the look of the course, and if you like the look of the college, then please do put in an application. It's a wonderful place to spend a few years, and quite aside from the academic pursuits, it's really, really heartening to see every year when another cohort of students graduate, that they've made some really strong friendships that we imagine will last a lifetime. And that's because, in part, they've found people who share their own enthusiasms, whether academic or outside the academic. We think you'll be very happy here, and we think you'll have many opportunities to grow academically, but also to grow as a person in other ways. So hope to see you soon.